Hi everyone, so in this video we are going to talk about use reducer hook. So this example we talked in the previous video and we are able to see this, it is working fine. We are able to change the name or we are able to change the email, so it is getting updated properly because on change of these properties we are actually triggering these actions: handle name change, email change, which are doing nothing but updating the state object particular properties, and we are able to see them. Okay. Now, next thing is, how can I use these use reducers multiple for the same function? So this is reducer function we have, right? Now, in this example, I will just use one snippet of the code to explain this example, something like this. So use reducer, there will be a reducer function somewhere, and that reducer function is doing increment decrement only, like something like this. Here we got two different instances of use reducer, count one and count two. Both will run fine, there will be no conflict will be happening. So if you wanted to dispatch on the first state, count one, it will be initially zero, and here you are actually dispatching this, dispatching that. So if you just see this, well, it's not defined. Okay, it's example three, so let's export that only. Okay, so both state are isolated, they are not impacting one another. You see, this reducer function is common and it is updating the state of the first one, updating the state of second one, right? So they can work. So what we did is, we wrote a one single reducer function and we created the two different instances of use reducer. So now count one will point to the state provided by the dispatch one functions, count two will be another state which will maintain the state provided by dispatch two. Similarly, you can have n number of instances based on your need. Here you can have a count three, another set of state, and dispatch three. But here in this, count three will be only updated whenever the dispatch three is getting called, right? So the action handler is assigned to dispatch three, dispatch two, dispatch one. So when they are getting triggered, the use reducer function will trigger, and based on the action dot type. So here we are sending the type right in the payload. You can also send some attribute if you want, and you can actually update the state based on that. So action.type is increment, decrement, set that we are checking, and based on that we are returning the new state object. Here it is just a number. Okay, but in real world when you wanted to use simple reducer, then you can actually make a multiple instance of that. Okay, so this is very important concept. When you write a real-time application, you have to create a multiple instance of use reducer. Okay, so I mean, this is we have covered everything in the use reducer hook. Now the another important part we will see is how to plug use reducer with a use context, because use reducer will not be used independently in the real world application. You will be used plugging it in with use context hook to make it more powerful. So you will not say, because these kind of stuff I can manage with a use state hook. I will have a state as an object and I will be updating this based on some DOM events. So what is the real use case? Use reducers and use context actually provide a lot of good things to the React component in terms of managing state or passing the props from one component to another component. That we will understand. First, we will talk about use context, what it do. Then we will combine use context and use reducer, and we'll see what benefits we are getting when we are using both of these together.